with Omicron, we now know that it is more contagious and more quickly contagious than some of the other variants that we've seen. So that's why the recommendation to upgrade from cloth to surgical if possible. And then again, if you're in a tight, packed space where you can't distance and there's a lot of people, to try to do an N95 if possible. So these are really nice. They're pretty inexpensive. These are all supposed to come with three layers, even though you can't see them as nicely as with some of the cloth masks. But this is a big reason why they're so popular, is because you know that if they're, you know, from a reputable distributor, for example, this one is from BYD, which is a reputable company, that you know you've already got the layers that you need. You don it essentially the same way. You put it around your ear and then kind of pull up here. Adjust your nose piece and then make sure you pull it down and around your chin so that you don't want your chin exposed and you don't want any portion of your nose exposed. So like for this one, here's one of the tricks that you can use both for yourself if you want a better fit and also for children if you have difficulty finding a smaller mask size. You can do what we call the tuck and knot method. So basically you fold the mask in half like this and then you make a knot on each side of the loop as close to the mask as you can. So I'll do that now. Okay, so I've got a knot here and it's pretty close, about as close as I can get it to the edge, and you do the same thing on the other side. Okay, and then what you do is you open the mask back up and then you take this excess material and you tuck it underneath this loop like so. And then you do the same thing on the other side. And then you don the mask like you did before. So the difference now is you've got this excess material tucked in nicely on either side. So as opposed to the sides being open, now I've got it a better seal here. So again, my nose is covered. I've got the malleable piece bent towards my nose. The sides are nice and tucked, and then I'm underneath my chin. And again, this trick will also work for people of smaller faces, and you can also use it for a child if you don't have a smaller mask handy for the kids to use. So a couple of common mistakes that we see are, you know, incorrect wearing, just putting it on without any sort of fit over the nose or over the chin. I see a lot of this, which is not very helpful because my nose is exposed, so I can expose others and I can easily get exposed. We also see a lot of, you know, the chin kind of hanging out on the bottom. And then again, just overall, not great fit. So again, the nose, the chin, and then that neat little trick that I showed where you can knot and tuck in the sides to kind of get in that gap. The other common mistake that maybe don't see, but I know that people do, is rewearing these masks way too many times. So the recommendation ideally is that you keep this on as long as possible. So for example, if you're going outside, outdoor, running errands all day long, then instead of taking it off, putting it on, taking it off, putting it on, it's best to just leave it on if you can, even when you're in your car driving to your next destination. The other thing too is a lot of times, you know, when we handle our masks, we're fussing with the inside and our hands are dirty, or the outside is dirty and now we're touching the inside of the mask, which is also not very helpful. And then they say no more than 24 hours for one of these masks, especially if it's visibly soiled or dirty. Even then, you really shouldn't wear it more than 24 hours. But again, if you do, and you do reuse it, you wanna be really careful about how, let's say I've worn this mask now. So when I take it off, I wanna make sure my hands are clean if possible. I wanna try to avoid touching the outside or the inside of the mask. Take it off like this, and then ideally you would store it by itself in something where it can breathe but is closed off. So a paper bag is a great example, like those old school lunch bags that we used to use. Just put it in there, and then when you're ready to use it, take it out by your ear loop. Again, try not to touch the mask, and then put it on again and make sure you've got the fit